The routing of ISIS in northern Iraq ought to be a time of international celebration, but as ever in the Middle East, there is no such thing as a straightforward victory. No sooner had ISIS been driven away, though not quite vanquished, than the next great struggle commenced, this time between the Iraqi government and the Kurdish forces who for the past 3 years have been holding back ISIS from the city of Kirkuk and its surrounding oil fields. This week, Iraqi forces stormed into Kirkuk and raised the country's official flag, removing the Kurdish flag which was raised there in 2014. While Kirkuk lies outside the semi-autonomous Kurdistan region agreed in 2005 to offer the Kurds some kind of homeland, it has for the past 3 years operated as part of that region, not least because it has been effectively cut off from Baghdad. The new battle for Kirkuk has become a proxy for the wider campaign for Kurdish independence, which culminated in an unofficial referendum last month where 93% supported secession. This was a strategic mistake. It antagonized Baghdad, which then grounded all international flights to Kurdistan. To complicate matters further, Baghdad appears to have enlisted the help of the Iranian Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, whose leader General Qasem Soleimani was in Kirkuk this week. For Iran, the battle for Kirkuk is a proxy for something different, a general power struggle where it hopes to subsume Iraq into its axis of Shia influence, and deny Israel the hope of an alliance with a democratic Kurdistan.